Hi, a very, very warm good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Annie Miraj Kidwai from Vertex, the solution of every need. How is everyone and how is everyone doing? I hope you're liking us and subscribing to our YouTube channel. I also hope that you're following us at Facebook. If there is any kind of questions, queries or doubts, you're more than welcome. You can find the links in the description box below to contact me. You can also leave your feedback in the comment section below. What I'm going to discuss to you in this video is about the workplace culture. It's very, very important, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm sure most of the corporate employees, private or government sectors, they're able to relate or correlate themselves with whatever I'm going to discuss in this video with you today. So this is a question. This is a question, one of the most asked questions by, you know, every employee in almost in every organization, because everybody faces this in some or the other way. So what to do with your toxic workplace culture? How to handle it? Number one, do not lose your cool. Do not lose your calm. Number two, be very, very patient. Be very patient. Number three, analyze what is happening and from where the toxicity of this culture is coming from your seniors, from your colleagues, from your juniors. So analyze it. So one thing is, the most important thing, if you lose your cool, if you lose your calm, you're not able to deal with the problem. Number two is that you need to be very, very patient, okay? And number three is that you need to be, you need to analyze the situation from where actually this is coming from. Now, at times it happens, you know, as the world is very competitive, and specifically the corporate industry is very, very competitive. So at times it happens, you know, workplace politics is not a new thing to discuss. It is everywhere. If it is from your colleagues or from your peers, it is important that we must ignore it. We must not appreciate, acknowledge it in anyhow. But if it is coming from your seniors at times, you know, I'm sure you must have faced these kind of personalities in your lifespan. There are different personalities, and sometimes those personalities hold powerful positions in organizations. You cannot change the perspective of an individual about you, so do not try it. And that also means that you shouldn't feel uncomfortable about your own skills and about knowledge and about your own qualifications. Sometimes when you are confident and when you're knowledgeable and when you are apt for the related job or for the related field you are into, at times people you know, pulls you down or drags you down. So you need to be very, very assertive. Be very, very assertive. Assertive does not mean that you need to disrespect anyone, but of course believing in your own self, and do not get diverted because of anything. Be assertive. And see, a very negative workplace cannot be handled, of course, if there is a lot of loopholes, or if there is a lot of what I would say, backlogs from the hierarchy, if it is coming from. But definitely what you can do at that point of time, the most important thing is always save your position, both legally and both financially. So saving yourself is very, very important in these kind of toxic cultures. And trust me, it drains your energy a lot. It makes you a lot of stress. So do not stress about it. Just laugh it off, and keep yourself financially and legally safe. Do not get involved into something which may hurt you both financially and legally. Secondly, of course, you cannot change the perspective of your bosses or seniors, or you cannot change anyone. If you have the flexibility, if your job is very good, suppose your position is very good and you are liking it, you have a lot of benefits, so at times when we have benefits, we need to compromise to certain situations in a way that it won't hamper the productivity of the organization and productivity of the employee as well. But definitely, if you are also not finding it apt in terms of the benefits, definitely these toxicities may happen, and the negativity of the organization makes the employees quit, and it hampers the productivity of the organization as a whole. In that case, nothing can be done, because in that sense, the organization is itself into a dilemma of coming out of such negativity or not. So in that case, nothing can be done, but still you do not stress out and keep your options always open. So keeping your options open is very, very important, ladies and gentlemen. This is how we deal with workplace politics or workplace toxicities or negativities. Private industries and corporate industries, everywhere, they face these kind of issues. The HRs are facing these issues. Communications happens a lot, you know. So keeping your communications clear and crisp, documenting everything is very important. So do document everything. It makes your points clear. It keeps you safe. And of course, afterwards, in any of the scenario, if you want to take in further action, you can take an action further, make a decision further about the same. So a few things I've told you how to deal with toxicities and negativities of the workplace is that: one, be very cool. Number two, be patient. Number three, analyze the situation. Number four, be assertive and be very, very confident, of course, on your skills, on your qualifications. Number six, keep your communication very, very clear. Do not get involved into grapevine communication. Grapevine communication is an informal communication when you're grouping, discussing things in a group, and then it's getting transferred to the hierarchy or to your superiors or to your bosses. So do not get involved in grapevine communications. But definitely, at times you have to do grapevine communications so that your voice can be heard to the hierarchy. That is the indirect communication about somebody. So, and the most important thing is that do not give an opportunity to anyone to decide on you. So the ball should always be in your court. So keep the ball always in your court. If it benefits you in ways, so definitely when there are some benefits related with the positions or with your profiles, you definitely take plunge somewhere to compromise. But definitely if it is not suiting you, you should keep your options open. So these are a few things about workplace culture. For more information or for more trainings, please contact us or leave us a mail. We'll definitely try to upload something relevant. Thank you so much and have a great day.